Residents battling to stop a McDonald's store in the Dandenongs show no signs of giving up their fight. Bulldozers were expected to move in this morning, but with protesters blockading the site, the heavy equipment stayed away. Michael Bennett has more.
Battle lines are drawn, McDonald's workers marking out the boundaries for the contentious development, but the action only spurred on protesters.
McDonald's! No, no, McDonald's!
Bulldozers were expected to move in this morning but stayed away, unlike a 24-year-old woman dubbed Roof Angel by her supporters. She and another demonstrator have been perched on the historic local cafe since Sunday.
1,170 people objected to this. The council backed that. 9 councillors to 0 said no. That should have been the end of it.
Crowds swelled in the morning, but as the day dragged on with no sign of movement, numbers dropped. Organisers say there's no indication when McDonald's will go ahead with the demolition.
We've been trying to set up a mediation between the CEO, Katrina Noble, and our elected representatives. That'd be our federal member, our state member and the councillors. They don't even return our calls on that.
Locals remain determined to protect the sanctity of their Hills home, even delivering their message to the fast food giant's headquarters in Sydney.
But 61,000 residents of Australia don't want to see a McDonald's built in the Dandenong Ranges. It's an iconic area. They're not wanted and they're not welcome.
McDonald's won't confirm the demolition date, but said the company had made countless design amendments to blend in with the environment.
Even though the crowds are dwindling here in Tecoma, the determination of this small town to fight McDonald's isn't dying.
We don't need a McDonald's here.
The people of Tecoma holding strong. Michael Bennett, 10 News.